Yesterday, Aaron Rodgers said he was donating $1 million to help with fire relief efforts in Northern California, where Rodgers grew up. Rodgers also asked fans to donate to help in the effort. And after that, Aaron was called out by his own brother, Jordan. Jordan tweeted, "Please donate, spread awareness, and send love. But when your own mom is home alone during the fires, car packed, ready to evacuate, and you miss the fundamental first step of compassion, calling your parents to make sure they are safe. Everything else just feels like an act." Shannon, what is your take on the situation?
I believe the situation could have been handled behind closed doors. I think it's been well documented that Aaron and his brother Jordan does not have the best relationship, and I don't really know. I guess from what I've only heard one side of the equation, because Aaron doesn't talk publicly about it, is that Aaron doesn't have the best relationship with a lot of his family members, be it parents, brothers, or whomever else is involved. Skip, I just believe, and it's just, this is heartbreaking to me because I know how close I am to my brother. Mm-hmm. I know how close I am to my sister. And we don't always disagree. We don't always agree, Skip. More so my sister and I, we get into heated discussions and we hang up the phone with each other and, you know, I call back or she'll call back, apologize, and we keep it moving. But it's just hard for me to believe that I would take this approach, because I believe the same approach that he took to Twitter, he could have all called Aaron. Maybe he doesn't have his number.
I don't think so.
Maybe he's trying to shame Aaron. Maybe he's trying to guilt Aaron into something. But I hardly think that if he's trying to start a relationship with Aaron and to get Aaron to come back to his family, be in the graces of his family, this is not how you do it, Skip.
Well, I don't think that was the idea here. I don't think that was the goal.
Whatever the goal. What did he hope Aaron's going to do? Because clearly,
he's calling him out, trying to expose him. As being a hypocrite.
But there has to be an end game. Okay, you call him out. Is that going to make Aaron have a different or a better relationship with his family? Because if you just call him out, it doesn't change the situation. What have you actually done? You made it even more difficult for him. Like I said, handle this. I just believe family matters. And Skip, you hear this a lot in sport. It's a family matter. We'll handle it indoors. We'll handle it inside.
Yeah.
This is real, true family that I believe could have been handled. I just don't really know where is Jordan taking this?
Look, did I wince when I saw this? Because you're airing your family's sort of dirty laundry,
right.
Yeah.
And it's pretty dirty here. It's pretty ugly.
You said family, not just Aaron.
No,
family.
It's family, and it's been going on for a long time, and it's been written about numerous times. But if it is true that Aaron did not call his parents, and I'm going to have to accept from his tweet that it is true, then there is some hypocrisy operating here. And the only reason I give it any credence or credit at all is obviously you're a big Aaron Rodgers fan. I'm not so much. And it's not the performance that I have issues with sometimes. There's sometimes I don't think he's real. I don't think he's true. I don't think he's what you think he's supposed to be.
Oh, I think he's everything. I think he's arrogant. I think he's smug. He's condescending. Okay. I think he's everything that you see. I think he's all that.
Okay. And then the bigger picture of this is we have this new age of the athlete actually promoting his brand by charitably giving to causes, to donating to causes. And it makes me a little uncomfortable because Aaron went to a studio and made a very professionally shot video. And it has a lot of good to it because he did give $1 million.
Right.
And he's encouraging others through his generosity to come with me here. You chip in a little bit and maybe it'll...
State Farm is going to match that up to $1 million.
It's J.J. Watt after the hurricane relief in Houston, right?
Yes.
But he did go so far as to say that this is a co-promotion with my, as he called it in the video, my longtime partner, State Farm. And it just makes me a little uncomfortable because they're involved. So there's some promotion of both the State Farm brand and the Aaron Rodgers brand. And I'm not just pinning this just on Aaron, because we see a lot of athletes publicly announce, I'm giving this.
Right.
And there's a part of me that wishes they would just do it privately, because it would mean more. And look, I don't want to get too religious here, but there's the reference in the Bible, it's Matthew 6:1, about don't take public credit for your donations or your charitable giving, because it'll be disqualified sort of in the eyes of God. And I again, that's going too deep for Thanksgiving Day, or maybe not. I don't know. But again, that resonates with me a little bit, because don't disqualify it by taking, don't use it for you to build your PR brand. Do it quietly. Do it out of your heart.
If you don't mind me asking, what's the difference between what he did by donating $1 million and said State Farm, mm-hmm. his business partner, is going to help, or his sponsorship, mm-hmm. than what J.J. Watt did?
Nothing. Zero. Same deal. So see, that's why I said I brought it up.
But a lot of people have the perception. And as I said, Aaron, I believe Aaron is all those things, because a lot of things can be true. Is
that's
he smug?
True.
I believe he's smug. Is he condescending? Yes.
Did this come from his heart? I believe it did.
Yes.
Does he care about those people in his home area?
Yes.
Yes, he does.
Yeah.
Does he have little to no relationship with his parents?
Yes.
Sounds like not.
Right.
That he doesn't have.
That is correct. And that's, look, everybody, you know, family is supposed to be sacred, and it's supposed, but everybody doesn't mm-hmm. have the greatest of mm-hmm. relationships with their family. I have a great relationship with my brother. I have a great relationship with my sister, my mom, my grandma. But I grew up like that, Skip. And there's nothing. And my grandma used to have a saying that says, son, sometimes teeth and tongue will fall out, but family should never fall out. Mm-hmm. There's nothing my brother and sister can do to make me stop talking to them. Mm-hmm. There's nothing my mom. My mom gives me upset, Skip, sometimes. Yes, she does.
Mm-hmm.
But there's nothing she can do. She gave me life. My grandmother, there's nothing they could have done.
But
for Aaron, look, like I said, whatever problem that I might have with a family or a friend, I ain't going on the internet. I'm going to go to you. If I got a problem with Skip, I'm going to Skip. If I got a problem with Jenny, I'm going to Jenny.
Mm-hmm.
Because whatever the problem is, how does going through social media, mm-hmm. if it doesn't help the end result, what have I done?
To be fair, here's Jordan trying to promote himself here. He was once on The Bachelor,
yeah.
right?
He's working in the industry
he
right
is.
Now, college
yep.
football analyst.
Okay.
And they talked about it on the show on
yep.
reality TV, and they
yep.
aired it out. And
it
was uncomfortable, and
okay.
he's doing it again.
Right. And Aaron strikes me as a private person. He's like, well, it happened with Illyria Munn and or his former ex-girlfriend. Look, for me, I try to stay. I've always tried to stay out. Like, my family, my brother, bruh. Oh, that's who you want to be? If you like, I love her. My mm-hmm. sister, that's your boy. If you like him, I love him. Mm-hmm. I don't get involved in stuff like that. Long as they treat you good. Jordan, Aaron, when the time is right, I believe everybody will eventually come home. And right now, he's got a lot going on, and maybe he's upset or with something you said or something someone's done.
Mm-hmm.
But eventually, I believe Aaron will come home. But this, I do not believe. Now, I could be wrong, Skip, but I don't believe handling something that can be handled private should be handled publicly.
Mm-hmm.
That's just me. I could be wrong, but that's just the way I like to do things.
And I don't believe something that could be private in charitable giving should be made public. That's just me.
But he just did it. Mm-hmm. So just give $1 million?
Yeah.
That's the hard part.
But how does he do that and also get people?
Okay, but
no,
now you're doing... It's dual pronged. You know, you're doing it to promote your brand and to say, well, gee, I'm encouraging others to give also.
Yeah.
So I get that.
Yeah.
So there's a little.
That's how charity
little
works.
Good
yeah.
and a little not good going on.
But that's how charity works.
Okay.
But maybe J.J. Watts looked a little bit more authentic because it felt like it wasn't planned out and that was received differently.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is that fair?
I'm sure. Did Aaron Rodgers think about giving his hometown or his community $1 million? Had these fires happened? Had not happened. Do you believe Aaron Rodgers would have donated $1 million to his community? Mm-hmm. Had that flood not happened, do you believe J.J. Watt would have raised $41 million for what? Mm.
I'm biting my lip.
There are things. Cause and effect.
Mm-hmm.
There was a cause.
Mm-hmm.
It was. Mm-hmm. This is what happened.
Okay.
But I believe Aaron Rodgers is a lot of things. I think we all are.
Okay.
It's like, Shannon, you're loud, you're arrogant, mm-hmm. you're this. Yeah, I'm a lot of things.
Mm-hmm.
It all depends on the time in which you catch
mm-hmm.
it. I can be nice. I can be, whoo.
Mm-hmm.
Stay
on the good side for
I'm going to enjoy a lot of State Farm ads today. I will.
You know what? I will take a shot there.
I like Gabriel.
No sarcasm.
He's my favorite agent.
Oh, he's your favorite agent.
Aaron Rodgers, he's one of my favorite players. I'm going to donate.
Well, we should all donate. It is for a good cause.
That is my
point
insurance
of this.
Company.
All right, we're going back to Cleveland. Was that? Are you trying to promote yourself there?
Maybe they give me a discount.
All right. LeBron returned to his old home last night. But should those Cleveland fans still be a little angry with him? We'll discuss next.